Oumuamua is the first object ever discovered to be of interstellar origin that has passed through our solar system. But now some astronomers are suggesting that it may in fact be of an alien origin. But not everyone's convinced, and for good reasons. Welcome back to Launchpad. I'm Christian Reddy, your friendly neighborhood astronomer. In October 2017, astronomers discovered a new kind of object that was unlike anything that we had seen passing through our solar system before. Namely because it was, well, literally passing through our solar system. The object was the very first of its kind, an interstellar asteroid that was discovered after it had passed closest to the sun and was on its way out of the solar system. Even though the object was too far and too faint to be resolved as anything other than a point of light, astronomers were able to measure its light as it varied over time. They concluded that it must be a rotating cigar-shaped asteroid. And that's a really strange shape because we don't seem to know of any cigar-shaped asteroids in our own solar system. But its velocity and trajectory are also very strange. It seems to have slingshot around our sun from interstellar space and is heading out into interstellar space once again. The object was given the name Oumuamua, Hawaiian for messenger from a distant place arriving first. On October 14th, 2017, Oumuamua passed within 0.16 astronomical units from Earth. That's relatively close. Even then, we didn't even discover it until after it had slingshot around the sun and began heading out of the solar system. By November of 2017, it crossed Mars's orbit, and by May of 2018, it had already passed Jupiter's orbit. In other words, Oumuamua is moving fast, about 25 kilometers per second fast. However, even at that rate, it won't leave our solar system for approximately another 20,000 years. Still, Oumuamua is getting farther away from us and growing fainter with each passing day. But that hasn't stopped astronomers from making yet more interesting discoveries about this strange object. Over the summer, a team using the Very Large Telescope in Chile noticed that Oumuamua was actually accelerating as it was leaving the sun. Now, this behavior is very strange for an asteroid, but it's not really too strange for a comet because that's what comets do. They release gas and dust as their surfaces are warmed by the sun. The outgassing material can act as like a thruster, which can help accelerate the comet forward a little bit as it leaves. But Oumuamua never showed any evidence of significant outgassing. There was no characteristic coma around the comet, there was no tail, nothing that would suggest that Oumuamua was cometary in nature. So astronomers began to consider other possibilities that might help explain Oumuamua's acceleration. In a new paper from Harvard University, astronomers Shmuel Bailey and Avi Loeb investigate the idea that maybe it's solar radiation pressure that could be accelerating Oumuamua. Light exerts pressure. It's a very weak pressure, to be sure, but in the vacuum of space, that pressure can build up over time and accelerate an object. However, in order for sunlight pressure to accelerate Oumuamua, it couldn't be shaped like an asteroid or even a cigar so much as it would need to be shaped like a, well, like a very, very thin pancake, less than a millimeter thick and about 50 meters across. Such a geometry would make Oumuamua a light sail instead of an asteroid. Lightsails have been proposed as a pretty inexpensive method of sending spacecraft to other planets and even out to other stars. All you need is a very large and highly reflective sheet of material that is facing the sun or maybe even like a laser propulsion system on the ground. Now, in their paper, the researchers demonstrate that a millimeter thin sail could in fact survive interstellar travel around the galaxy. It could survive minor impacts from particles of the interstellar medium. It could handle torques induced by sudden rotations from stellar winds. It could even deal with galactic cosmic rays penetrating over tens or even hundreds of thousands of years. However, we've never actually seen a solar sail in nature, so the authors of the paper go on to consider artificial origins. And since Oumuamua passed very close to Earth, it may have very well been an intentionally sent probe. Okay, now that I've told you the backstory, let me also add that I find these claims of alien origin to be very unconvincing. Oumuamua did pass close to Earth, but that does not mean it was intentionally sent to Earth. It could just be that it had to pass close enough to Earth in order for it to set itself up on a trajectory that would allow us to discover it in the first place. In fact, it's estimated that there could be something like 1,000 of these Oumuamua-type objects passing in and out of our solar system every year. The Large Synoptic Survey Telescope will be able to make very wide-field, yet very deep, images of the entire sky every several days. It will be able to capture all kinds of new asteroids, comets, and even interstellar interlopers passing across the sky. So I think we're going to be seeing a lot more examples that will help us to understand the nature of Oumuamua far better. Another problem is that Oumuamua is moving way too slowly to be suitable for interstellar travel. An interplanetary light sail, let alone an interstellar light sail, would need to be kilometers wide in order to accelerate to thousands or even tens of thousands of kilometers per second. Oumuamua is just too small and too slow for that job. Now, the whole idea of radiation pressure as the source of acceleration was invoked because Oumuamua doesn't seem to be a comet. But just because it doesn't seem to be a comet doesn't mean that it isn't a comet. Whenever we see comets with their beautiful comas and tails, we're seeing dust bursting out from inside the comet. But if Oumuamua had been tumbling through interstellar space for all of these years, it's entirely possible that galactic cosmic rays or magnetic torques or even encounters with other stars could have fundamentally changed its surface chemistry. Maybe the only thing that is outgassing from Oumuamua is just gas itself, and that's going to be really hard to pick up. In other words, Oumuamua may in fact be outgassing like a comet, and that's what's accelerating it out of the solar system. Invoking aliens is a great way to make headlines, but it always turns out to be a losing bet. A recent example was Tabby Star. One hypothesis to explain its erratic drop-off in light was that maybe there was a civilization around the star that was building a Dyson swarm, that is, an array of collectors to harness the star's energy. It was a wild hypothesis, but that's what everybody seized on, and people started to get really disappointed when they found out that, sure enough, it was dust that was causing the drop-off in light from the star. You know, in science, we get things wrong all the time, and that's okay, because by getting things wrong, we eventually get to the right answer. But when astronomers from Harvard University make claims of alien probes, the public assumes that the astronomers must be right. They're from Harvard, after all. So when we find that there really is a natural explanation for Oumuamua's acceleration, well, you could see how this is going to play in the public. Now, don't get me wrong. I would love it if we had conclusive evidence that we were not alone in the universe. But we gotta be careful and thoughtful as we explore an incredible universe in which we live. So if you'd like to join me on this journey through this amazing universe of ours, I invite you to subscribe and ring that notification bell so that you don't miss out on any new videos. Until next time, keep watching the skies.